All right, guys, for years my kids have asked me to write down all my recipes and so forth, and I've never taken the time to do it, so I had the bright idea of using this little GoPro camera and videoing my recipe, watching me make it, seeing it happen. So this is real time. We've gone ahead and prepped a lot of the stuff ahead of time just to make it a little bit easier. So of course we've diced up our Trinity, which is celery, onions, bell peppers. We did two full stalks of celery, and we've got there's three bell peppers and probably four medium onions. That's just regular white onion. Some people like purple. That is what it is. This here is going to be our fried turkey gumbo. And again, we're live. People are going to be passing through. Comments are going to be made. You never know who's going to walk in the door. Dog's getting a little extra food every once in a while. It's real life, real time. So sit back and enjoy. I hope you get to learn a little bit of something. Macy's going to be helping me do this as we go along. The other thing we've already started, these are two things that we've already done ahead of time too. We're going to make a potato salad to go with it, because any good gumbo, and people who love gumbo are going to love potato salad also to go along with it. Some people like rice, some people like potato salad, some people like both. We're the potato salad people. So that comes from the Kunan side of Louisiana. And we've adapted it up here in North Louisiana. This is, I want to say my own creation. It's a fried turkey gumbo. I done it 1 year after we fried a turkey for Thanksgiving. We were tired of eating turkey and ham and all that. So Christmas time I did a gumbo, and I did it out of the fried turkey bones. So yesterday we did the same thing for Easter. We fried a turkey. Just having fun, picking my nose over the pot. Well, family's gonna come in and help us too. So anyway, fried a turkey yesterday. We eat turkey. Blessed it on the day that the Lord rose, Easter. So today is April 13th, 2020, and we're quarantined, so we have a little time to do stuff like this. So anyway, we deboned. We ate turkey last night after deboned. These are the bones off of that turkey. I boiled it for probably an hour or so to get the broth. That's the main thing I'm going after. I will pick through and get some of that meat off of there, but we got a pretty hefty pile of meat left. So we got, I don't know, probably 2 pounds, 2.5 pounds of turkey meat left off of that. I also went ahead and cut up 2 pounds of sausage, one of our favorites right here. And you see some of the other ingredients that are going to go in here. We're going to make a real roux as we go along. Hopefully the battery holds up. We're going to have enough here. And somehow or another we can figure out how to upload it for everybody. So I'm going to start. I'm going to drain this out so we can get our broth. Well, I have that glass bowl out of there. It works a little bit better. How to burn yourself. It is unsafe.
Can I send you the phone? To look at the camera?
Sure.
Alright. We have a strainer and a bowl.
Pretty straightforward there. Watch out, Finn. It's hot. Liquid gold right there. What'd I tell you? I knew somebody'd be pulling up. I figured it was. We're going to use that later.
That's the broth.
What, honey? My father. What's up?
Door's always open.
I didn't know. Is it just GoPro or is it?
Yeah, it's just we're making a recipe.
We're doing a live recipe.
You can talk. No big deal.
She can't.
Can I get some firewood?
She can't be quiet anymore. Hope she sees that one day.
She will. Yeah. I said, Jesse, you can talk. He said she can't be quiet anyway. I hope she sees that.
We're done with that pot. We're actually going to use this pot, move in to make our gumbo.
This is the gumbo pot.
This is gumbo pot, what it is. It's had a few gumbos on it. I always judge a good gumbo pot by how many times somebody beat their spoon on the side. But anyway, it's had a few years there. What we're going to do first, we're going to brown our sausage. We're going to brown the sausage first, pull it out, and then we're going to use that grease that's in there, add some butter to it. Yes, we're going to use real butter. And we're going to do the celery. And I always do my celery first, but I'll get to that whenever I get there. So let's get our sausage browning first, and we'll work on the veggies. Sausages are a different breed. Everybody's got their own opinion on it. Around here, this is a well-known favorite sausage. There's all kinds of brands, and this is not my most favorite. Well, this is one of my most favorites, but some people like to use fresh sausage. We don't have a fresh meat market, but sometimes you can brown fresh sausage. That makes it good. Andouille sausages are really good. This is just a standard smoked, hickory smoked sausage. A lot of flavor to it, puts off a good fat whenever you're doing it. You do want a little bit of a fatty sausage, so whenever you do cook it down, you have grease left over so you can cook your vegetables.
It tastes better.
Only thing I don't like about these guys, they're from Alabama. That's the bad thing about it. I don't want to give it to them, but they do make a good sausage. They can't play football with it, but they do make a good sausage.
Here's our dogs.
Enjoy. Begging. Want to see a trick?
Here we go. Wait, good. Can you see him? Yeah. There we go.
Want to see Rad do it?
Aw, she tried.
Potato salad, if you want to know how to make a potato salad, go online and find one, or if your grandma makes a good one. We do a basic potato salad. I'm not big on mustard. I do a little bit of mustard, but I cook potatoes down till they're a little soft. I don't like them to get soft and make mashed potatoes, so we'll cook them down, we'll cool them off a little bit in a little cool water. There's salt in there, the only thing in it. After we take that off there, we mix in a little mayonnaise, maybe a little salt, pepper, some pickle relish. Some people put eggs. Actually, we like olives too. That's another big thing that we put in there. So a few things. However you like your potato salad is good. Some people like mustardy. I'm not a big fan of. Just is what it is. That's part of it. Sound like a bell ringing. What I was saying earlier about as that cooks, when I was talking about celery, my wife does not like celery. And for years I had to hide the fact that I put celery in it, and she caught me one day putting celery in my gumbo, and she's like, I don't like celery. I said, I know you don't like celery. So what I do is after I cook my sausage down, I have my grease in there, add some butter to it, and we saute this first. And it cooks down pretty good. And then I add